Hello, this is Eric at Ridley Wright Stuff. This is going to be the first video in a series that will describe how to clean and maintain each of the components of a Ridley Wright Stuff carbon fiber tripod. The purpose of this first video is to familiarize yourself with the different terminology that I will use throughout the series of videos, describing each of the components and identifying them. Starting with the top of the tripod. Here we have the apex. The apex is essentially the crown or the top of the tripod. It's where each of the three leg sections meet, and it's where your tripod head will mount to the tripod itself. The apex consists of two components: the triangular shape apex, or the circular collar, and then the tripod platform. To loosen this system from the apex, you have to loosen three set screws. Once the screws are loosened, you should be able to remove the platform from the apex. The circular platform for a 4 series here is going to be fairly large, whereas here we have one for a 2 series, much smaller. Inside the apex, we have a stainless steel ring. This ring is part of the SureGrip apex system and is what keeps your platform securely locked to the apex. Also part of the apex system are the three set screws that reside on each of the different sections of the apex. The next major component is the clevis. The clevis resides at the top of the carbon fiber tube section and mates at the leg angle joint of the apex. Here I have a fully assembled leg angle joint system and all of its components in their proper place. Going backwards, disassembling, we have your wrist pin screw, which should have a nylon patch. Then we have the wrist pin itself, which is what resides between the apex and the clevis joints. You can see here that it should be freely rotating between the clevis and the apex bore. There should be nothing preventing its rotation. Once removed, we now have the two washers that reside between the apex and the clevis. These prevent any friction or wear and tear between the tripod clevis and the apex. Lastly, we have the pull tab assembly. On the 4 series and 1 series tripods, the pull tab assembly mostly resides on the tripod clevis, whereas in a 2 and 3 series, the pull tab assembly is a completely removable and independent system. As part of the pull tab assembly, we have the pull tab itself, the black insert, and then your pull tab spring. Moving on, we have the weight hook, which resides underneath your apex on the threaded stud. We have the anti-twist sleeves or shims that reside between each carbon fiber tube section. We have a twist lock assembly, which consists of the female portion, the rubber overmolded twist lock, and then the anti-twist gib. The gib resides within the assembly, which I've removed here so you can see what it looks like, but normally it resides inside the twist lock itself. The last component we have is the tripod foot, which can either be a stainless steel rock claw, spike foot, or as we have here, a rubber ball foot. And those are all of the components in a Ridley Wright Stuff carbon fiber tripod. If you have any other questions, do feel free to give us a call, but go ahead and watch the next series where we'll go through the diagnostics of how to determine what maintenance might be necessary for each of these components. This is Eric at Ridley Wright Stuff, thanking you for watching.